It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle-belling and everyone telling you it's time for good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Well, welcome to Bobby Seagull's Quiz for NHS Christmas Special. Don't adjust your set. You've not got the wrong time of the year. It is actually June the 27th. But in 6 months' time, we've had Christmas Day, Boxing Day, and we'll be sitting there on our sofas going, oh my God, what have I eaten? I've eaten so much. So I thought, you know, since we're in lockdown, or sort of lockdown, let's have a joyous time with a Christmas special. And thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me. Are you ready? So, round number one. Let's get going. Okay, question number one. So, five questions, school-related, and we're going to get kicking off. Round number one. Okay, to spell Santa Claus, the surname, we can use the periodic table of elements. So, if we have the Cl for chlorine, and we have the S for sulfur. What element in the periodic table is a U? So we have Cl for chlorine, S for sulfur, and Au is what particular element? Welcome to Nikki on Instagram. Welcome to Joanne Baldwin. Welcome. So the question is, to spell Claus, we're missing an Au. What element in the periodic table stands for Au? There we go, a bit of science to start you off. Hope you've been revising. On University Challenge, periodic table always comes up. You've got to memorize all 118 elements. Someone's got to do it. Okay, question number two. In what 1800s decade was Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol published? And I'll give you plus or minus one decade leeway. Or decade. So in what 1800s decade was Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol published? So plus or minus one decade. Give me a decade. And I'm being generous. I don't know why I am being generous. So that is question number. Hello to the Tibbs. That's question number. So have a think. Charles Dickens. Is it decade or decade? The big controversy of 2020. Controversy or controversy? I'm stirring up lots of things today. Stirring lots of things. All to go on that Christmas pudding. Okay, question number three. In the 12 Days of Christmas song, multiply the number of gold rings by the number of calling birds, and what number do you get? So in the 12 Days of Christmas song, multiply the number of gold rings by the number of calling birds. Bit of maths there. Welcome to the Clarks. Welcome to the LAs in Chichester. Hello. That's question number three. A bit of maths with Christmas. So multiply the number of gold rings by the number of calling birds in the song. Emily Butt saying scone or scone. I recently dated someone from up north, and funnily enough, after a few weeks, I started saying things in a northern way. But I'm back to southern. I'm back with southern. So I now would call it scone, but I know northerners say scone, don't they? Say scone. Okay. Question number four, penultimate one, round number one. So I want you to spell this word, a bit of romance in the air. So I want you to spell the word that means evergreen plant in Latin, viscum album. But the word is mistletoe. Can you spell the word mistletoe for me? If you're lucky, Christmas Day, mistletoe, there we go. So spell the word mistletoe for me. Hello, Team Mac. They've got their Christmas jumpers, I'm very impressed. I'm very, very impressed with Team Mac and their Christmas jumpers. Is this the earliest ever Christmas event that you celebrated?
For me it is. For me it is. Okay, question number 5. True or false? It's a popular tradition for Japanese families to treat themselves to McDonald's on Christmas Day. Is it true or false? It's a popular tradition for Japanese families to treat themselves to the Golden Arches, McDonald's on Christmas Day. That's your final question. And again, on my Sunday Times. Oh, someone's asking a very good question. They said, is it the total number of rings or just in one particular verse? You don't need to add up. Nothing complicated for question number 3. It's just the number of rings in one particular verse multiplied by the number of calling birds. That's all it is. Okay. Chris Shirov is doing very well on Instagram. Well done. Well done. Oh, if you're on any of the channels, try not to put the correct answer in. So, okay. We'll go backwards and we'll go through the answers in a second. So question number 4 was, spell the word mistletoe. Question 3, multiply the number of gold rings by the number of calling birds in one particular verse. Maybe in the last verse. You don't have to add up all the gold rings. Question number 2, what decade was Charles Dickens' Christmas Carol? And AU stands for what element? Okay, 10 second Christmas dance. 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's your time. Time's up. Okay. How have we done? Let's have a look. Round number one. So, AU, I'm looking at you. It's gold. Gold. If you put silver, unlucky. Like, you know, silver's AG, like Argentina, Argentarius, land of silver. But AU is gold. So question number 1 is gold. Question 2, so it was published in the 1843. So if you put 1840s is correct. If you've got 30s or 50s, give yourself a mark. So 1840s, 30s to 50s gives you a mark. So unlucky, Nikki, you got 63. I wanted, you need to be 30s, 40s or 50s. Question number 3. 5 gold rings, 4 calling birds, 3 French hen, 2 turtle doves. So it's 5 times 4, which is 20. In decimal system. So 20, this one, ooh, mistletoe, I better get this right. M-I-S-T-L-E and then T-O-E, toe. So M-I-S-T-L-E-T-O-E, mistletoe. There we go, mistletoe. And the last one, sneaky little question. If I changed McDonald's to KFC, it would have been true, but it's not McDonald's, so it's false. It is false, the answer. They eat KFC, it's a big tradition. Millions of people have to order KFC in advance for Christmas Day. It's a big tradition in Japan. So KFC is the answer, so the answer is false. Although my family, my cousins and I, we went to, so I'll put the answers up for you. My cousins and I, we went to California a few years ago, 2014 Christmas. And on Christmas Day, guess we went for Christmas dinner. We went to McDonald's and we're looking at all these people thinking, who are these people? Look at them, Christmas Day, McDonald's, and yet we were there as well. So I've had McDonald's on Christmas Day. Let me know your scores. Again, my classes that I'm up to. Again, Mondays are meant to be maths days, but I seem to have lots of interviews on Mondays, probably because all the media like, oh, Monday's the day we do things. But anyway, always geography on Tuesdays. Wednesdays is my football quiz. Thursday is history, and then Saturday is my family quiz. And this week's class has been really great fun. On Tuesday, we looked at South Africa, and we looked at the South African national anthem. And one of my primary school teachers, Mrs. Lang, she's a Scottish lady who lived in Malawi, in Africa. So she taught us the South African national anthem. So I knew all the words. Kosi sikeleli Africa, malu pandemi supondewayo. Is by him at Andazu, yea, to Kosia Sikalela. I know the South African national anthem. Pretty cool, isn't it? And then on Thursday, we looked at Winston Churchill. Now, obviously, we've had, you know, there's been a bit of controversy about the statues debate, but we did a really balanced look at Churchill. You know, obviously, he's a clear hero, but also looking at some of the negative things that he did as well. So again, it's a great class. They're up on YouTube if you want your kids to have a balanced class, but fun as well. We did some 40s, jitterbug, swing dancing as well. And then I always get homework. I get amazing homework. Oscar sends in through lots of posters. Karina was doing the Vosho dance. Have you heard of the Vosho dance in South Africa? They sort of do like, squat and kick. It's called the Vosho. Boop, boop. Karina was doing that. And then Hayden and Lisa sending in some fabulous posters of the class. So my classes, come along. They're really exciting. Thank you so much.